Hello and welcome, and here is I have video in Toyota cars that what is problem in Toyota Corolla's VVT-i engines when this idle speed is moving up and down when we have this engine is hot and warm. And now we can see that this temperature meter shows that the engine is like this normal running speed, but this idle is moving up and down in that way. And when I accelerate a little bit more, it comes back in here. Okay, interesting. And then we go to investigate that issue in engine area.
Okay, and now we are in this engine area, and we need to look then this engine's fuel injection line and this throttle body, that part where this gas pedal goes in that way. This is throttle body. This is throttle body. And next we look that part. And here is especially that one where is this cable. And then when we look in the cable, we can see one screw in here. And let's go to look that closer. Okay, and here is this first possible issue was that when there is this intake manifold, that this gasket what is in here, that there was some leak. And then we go to look next possible issue area. Okay, and here we have this throttle body, and it is easy to find when we have air filter in here. And here we have intake manifold, and there is engine. And this is throttle body, and then when we look in, this is gas pedal cable that goes in here. And when we look in here down, there is this idle speed sensor. Its location is in there. And there is radiator, and there is throttle body. And this is engine. Okay, and here when we have this throttle body, the second issue area is this sensor part in here, what is this idle speed sensor area, where those coolant comes in and out, in here, this part. And that's, we need to open that area next. Okay, and now I have better screwdriver and I try to open this. This seems to be really tight bolts, and that's I need to go to open these bolts in my workbench next. Okay, and now I am in my workbench and there is this my screws. But I need to next open, and I need next my hammer. There's my hammer, and there's my this screwdriver, and now I am using this. I insert, by the way, this my throttle body in this workbench. Now it's fasten, and then I try to open this bolt so that I hit a little bit that my tool in here. There is my hammer, and I hit. And now I believe that I can open this box. Okay, and now it opens, look, great. Now this box opens. I can rotate good. Then I open next bolt. what is in here, and then also hammering. What happens? Okay, this is still stuck. How about then this final next one in here? It is also stuck, and I need to hammer this more. Okay, this opens. Position. Okay, and these are very stuck in here, but I continue this opening. Okay, and here we have then this issues, the main point. If we have any issues in our hot and cold temperature engine, that we have idle speed issues, that car don't run nicely like in hot engine, then we need to check this idle speed control valve, and it looks like that. Normally it is in one area in this throttle body, and it is easy to know that normally there goes two coolant hoses in and outline, and then we need to open these bolts what are in here, four pieces, and sometimes they are easy to open and sometimes not, like in that my case that I must cut these bolts because they were so tight. But I need to install new bolts back. And then when I opened that my idle speed control valve, there we can see that in that area there moves this coolant liquid. And how it works with this idle speed console? This coolant water and this liquid goes in these holes in and out, and there in that area there is this control valve in here inside in there. We can maybe see a little bit, and then when we like to check that what is this control valve status, there is idea that there came those electric cables. We need to open those two bolts more, and they were also very tight, and I need to cut those bolts. But then, when I manage to open those, I can take this part out, and there is the issue. This my valve is totally rusty. And now this my valve, it don't move, because these all parts are rusty. And then, when it don't move, it don't change this electric adjusting device, those amounts and values. That is this big value or small value, because this control sensor measures these bars and this rod's movement, and now this is totally stuck. Can you see that it is totally rusty? Okay, and how to fix then that kind of issue? Normally we need to purchase new sensor, or sometimes if we take tongs, we can maybe to lubricate that, and next I take my tongs and we look that can I make this part to move again. Okay, here are my tongs, and then I try to rotate, look that part in here. Can I rotate that when I take my tongs in here and I press that one, that can I move that so that now there is cool grip and then I rotate this. Oh no, this went broken. Because this is so rusty. Normally this part should move. But this is too rusty. Sorry. And that means that I can't anymore repair that. Okay, but I tried. But no worry, we can purchase new part and then install it back in here. And this was this my video's idea that how to check if you have idle speed issues. Please check your idle speed, this temperature sensor and valve. Okay, and now when I have replaced this throttle body, you can see that now there is this idle speed is okay, no any vibration, and everything is fine. And then there's those issues, reasons are and where I think that the leaks, those gasket leaks, and then of course this throttle body things. But now everything works well. Okay, and let's go to look those issue areas next.